flowers, chocolates. Hindi nyo alam kung anong something, di ba? Siyempre, siyempre, nahiya ako sa mga single. Ah. Mag-asawa, iba yung something sa utak niyo. Okay. How about yung mga nagkatanggap ng flowers or chocolates noong February 14? Taas kamay nga. Sige na, maging proud naman din kayo. Oh. Sa mga nagtaas ng kamay, sa K-shop po ba bumili, Kuya R? Okay. Okay. How about raise your hand if you are part of the Blessed Fam? Yan, dami nating couples. Blessed Fam is our couples ministry dito sa church. How about in a relationship but not yet married? Parang wala masyadong gusto magtaas. Undeclared po ba yan? Taas kamay ang mga single. Taas kamay lang po, may sumisigaw na. Ayan. You don't have to raise your hand, but I'm like, allow me to just ask this. How many of you came from a broken family? How many of you came from a mother or a father who is a single parent? Or at some point, baka hindi pa kasal ang parents mo. Or you know people who are in a broken home. No need to raise your hands, but allow me to show these pictures. I mean, to this. Yeah, that's a picture for me. So, okay. These words. Broken families, divorce, broken homes, annulment, single parents, live-in. Habang tinitingnan natin yung slide na yan, what do you feel? Positive, negative? Negative agad, di ba? Wala pa naman tayong ine-explain, but just by merely looking at it, automatic the message is negative. Now, I believe itong series for the whole month is talking about indivisible. We would want to make sure that this church would produce a culture that is a whole family. For single people, we desire na ang ating family na ibibuild will be whole. It's godly. Because in reality, today, this is so real and evident. Now, accordingly to studies, there are four common reasons, common out of the many reasons why there are broken homes. One, early pregnancy. People are forced or a woman is forced to get married because may nangyari. Forced to get married even if medyo shallow pa ang relationship. Why? It's normal nowadays. Kaya ang daming teenage pregnancy, 2020 pa lang po. Kahit pandemic, mas madaming kaso sa barangay. Why do I know this? My mother is in the barangay. I hear that. That's early pregnancy. Kaya forced marriage. Panagutan mo na lang. Another reason, societal pressure. Sa mga medyo lumalagpas na sa kalendaryo, ang tanong lagi, kailan ka mag-aasawa? Kailan ka magkaka-love life? Lahat ng batchmates mo kasal na. Lahat ng batchmates mo may anak na. Ikaw. Or, at some point, another societal pressure, yung bang, pwede na yan. Huwag ka nang masyadong ma-standard. Di ba? Push mo na yan. Di ka na bumabata. That's pressure. Right? To the point na ang pressure would leave out your standard in life. Just to please people. Another, infidelity. Meaning, third party. Meaning, masyado daw kasi magaganda ang mga babae. Masyado daw magaganda ang mga Filipino women. Walang gusto mag-amen, so walang maganda dito. Yung totoo. My point is that, yung temptation, because that's normal. Right? People see going from one relationship to another as something na in sa ngayon. And last reason or common reason why there are broken homes, faulty foundation. What do I mean by that? In the Philippines, most marriages are based on emotional bond. Feelings. Meaning, kapag mahal ko, magpapakasal na kami. Kami na agad. Yung ganun, hindi lumalalim ang relationship. That we forget that marriage or or commit, marriage is all about commitment. It's not just about feelings. Amen ba, blessed fam? Please po, mag-amen po kayo. Wala po akong credibility dito tumayo, actually. But talking about this, sabi ko, why is a single person going to speak about this? Because I would want to declare that to my family later on. I will not have a broken home. I will not have broken marriage. Amen? Single people, amen? Amen. Parang ayaw mag-amen. Wala mo gina-declare para sa love life. That's the whole point. And since we would want to make sure that we create a culture that is indivisible, hindi basta-basta mabibreak, hindi basta-basta magse-separate, that's the kind of marriages we want in the church. That's the kind of family we want to make a church in the church. Isn't it? As married couples, yes, the two becomes one, but individually, you contribute to make it whole. Dave Willis said, if every couple quits when marriage got difficult, 100% of couples would be divorced. If couples quit just because it's hard. Challenges in your marriage are an opportunity to work together, not an excuse to give up on each other. You can't save a relationship unless both people are equally invested. It takes a joint effort to make it work. Blessed fam, amen po ba? In a relationship, people, amen po ba? Kailangan ko talaga ng amen ninyo this morning. Right? And I believe, kahit anak ka, sa mga single na nandito na hindi mo alam kung saan ka kukontribute ngayon, bilang anak, bilang part of a family, you also contribute to the totality of your family, to the unity of your family. Meaning, individual po ang contribution natin. No matter if it's 0.01% only, ang contribution mo, it would matter for the totality. Amen? We want families to work. We want that your marriage would work, your relationship will work, your family to be whole, you have to be intentionally invest your life in becoming a contributor to make it whole and not a contributor to divide it. And I hope individually today, we see ourselves that I have to be that. I have to be intentionally be that. So I can contribute to make sure relationships, families, I will build, I am in, will be undivided. Do we want that? Let's pray. Every head bow, every eyes close. To our most graciously Heavenly Father, Lord, this morning we commit everything to you. We thank you for your presence that we felt during praise and worship. Lord, let your presence continuously, O God, Lord, be so evident and be manifested in this place. Let your word, O God, Lord, speak to your people in a very personal way. In the limitedness of your servant, God, have your way. Holy Spirit, speak to your people through me, O Lord. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart give you the glory that you deserve, O God, Lord. Let your purpose be accomplished through this sermon. All this, O God, Lord, we pray in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Meaning, our individual role contributes to make things indivisible. To make marriages, families, relationships be indivisible. Now, ano yung gusto nating titingnan ngayon? Individual po. Kasi po, single po ang kausap nyo. Okay? In Galatians 2:14 to 19, medyo mahaba siya, no? Pero I would like to give you a glimpse of it. This is actually Apostle Paul confronting and opposing Peter. Wait lang. Apostle Paul, medyo huli-huli na po si Apostle Paul. Nauna po si Peter bilang mga disciple ni Jesus. Why is it that Apostle Paul would oppose a long-term disciple? What happened? The Word of God says, when I saw that they were not following the truth of the gospel, this is Paul speaking. Sino kaya yung not following the truth? I said to Peter in front of all the others, since you, a Jew by birth, have discarded the Jewish law and are living like a Gentile, Why are you now trying to make this Gentile follow the Jewish traditions? You and I, Jews by birth, not sinners like the Gentiles. Yet we know that a person is made right with God by faith in Jesus Christ, not by obeying the law, and we believe in Jesus Christ so that we might be made right with God because of our faith in Christ, not because we have obeyed the law. For no one will ever be made right with God by obeying the law. Doon na lang siguro muna tayo. I will not read it later because babalikan lang natin yan mamaya. Point, bakit nag-oppose si Apostle Paul? It's because Peter is living as if he is not a Jew. Peter is living as if he's a sinner and not made right by God. How many times are we carrying the badge of a Christian but our lives doesn't speak Christianity? Meaning, kahit matagal na po si Peter sa paglalakbay, posible pa ring makalimot. And sometimes, we are both Christian in this marriage, in this relationship, in this home, but we tend to forget and act as Christians. We're like others. Tatira plato, tatira. Diba? Pag umaga pa lang, bago pa tumilaok yung manok, mas maingay pa ang boses ng sino. Minsan nakakalimutan natin yun within our homes. Why? Because inside our homes, that's comfort. We're too comfortable inside, but we forget who we are inside. That's the whole point. Meaning, in the same way, Paul was confronting Peter. Because that's a tendency we have. We live in this world like the view of the world and expect people to be invited to church. Imagine. Peter, acting like a Gentile, expecting Gentiles to live like a Jew. When a Jew could not live as a Jew. With many broken homes and families today, we want to make a change, and that change should start from us individually. Until we become intentional in becoming individuals who pursues to be better people, then we'll see relationship working in unity. That's why this morning we're going to talk about intentionally indivisible. I, because ikaw yan, hindi tayo. The control we have is ourselves, our individual selves. Tama po ba? Or baka Blessed Fam would agree that you now control your other half. Siya na yan, ubo, OMG. Individually, intentionally, indivisible. There are three ways in becoming intentionally indivisible contributors. Number one, you have to be separated from your old self. You have to be separated from your old self. Anong sabi ni Apostle Paul in verses 19 to 20? When I tried to keep the law, it condemned me. So I died, say the word I died. I died to the law. I stopped trying to meet all its requirements so that I might live for God. My old self has been crucified with Christ. It is no longer I who live, but Christ lives in me. So I live in this earthly body by trusting in the Son of God who loved me and gave himself for me. Individually, we have to set a difference. Individually, we have to set a standard. Meaning, individually, you have to remember who you are. Remember what you believe in. Apostle Paul is trying to point out, it is no longer I who live. Dahil kung siya ay sumasabay sa law, sumasabay sa mundo, it condemns him. Bakit? Malaki na yung gap natin. It took a cross to fill in the gap between us, the world, with God. That's how wide, that's how big the gap is. Meaning, it is no longer you who live. Alam ko man yan past, but how do you live your life? Pero sa galing may tumawa ngayon, di ba? May lumilipad na plato, may lumilipad na baso. Mas malakas pa yung boses ng sino man kaysa sa radyo. Bato-bato sa langit, ang tamaan, mag-repent. The first difference we have to set in our mindset, in our society, is that we are not alike the world. Bago ka na, ibang tao ka na, iba na ang buhay mo. And Paul, to think na mas late pa siya kay Peter dumating when it comes to becoming a disciple, he reminded Peter about this stand. Because Christians like Peter tends to forget. Our lack of awareness. Our lack of awareness on how we live our life. Example, when we came from IDC, first night, nakasabay po ako kina Senior Pastor Mark sa kotse. Simple lang po talaga, 3 basement kasi ang CCF. So nasa pinaka-third po kami kasi punuan talaga. And the topic of IDC is known by love. Pero pagdating sa garahe, gusto lahat mauna. E traffic, dito magkakaalaman sino ang known by love. Magpapabigay ka ba ng daan? Alternate ba kayo? O gusto mong pumito at pumito para lang makalabas ka? Tapos galing pa yan sa known by love na conference. Because sometimes we forget. We act as if we are Gentiles. We forgot we are made right with Christ. Are we aware of that? If you will be given an opportunity to evaluate your life today, how far different is your life than the moment you met Christ? I passed. Bagong-bago na talaga ako ngayon. Malayo na talaga ang pinagkaiba ko last time. Dati, sobra talaga akong maldita. Ngayon, maldita na lang, hindi na sobra. How are we looking at our actions? Pag may issues ba sa Facebook, kasabay kang nagrarant? Hindi ka nga nag-post, pero nasa comment section ka naman. Hindi ka nga nag-comment, nag-heart ka naman. Ay, isn't it? Hala, nakita ko, Raymond Roy has heart this post. Sa iba, wala lang yun. Pero ang point sa akin, ang message, sinusuportahan niya si ganito. Are you getting what I'm trying to say? Our action, even if hindi mo intention, sends a message. Reflects who you are. Now, if you look at your life, what would people think? You as a father, you as a mother, you as a husband, you as a wife. Based on your actions. Hindi mo matatanggal ang sarili mo na minsan lumalabas yung sariling dating ikaw. Because we live in this flesh, that sinner, that see us as a sinner. But we have to remember who we are. That's why in order to contribute to unity, in order to contribute a culture of indivisible marriage relationship and a lot of things, old self should be separated. Amen? I hope the word speaks. Stop trying to live by the law. Stop trying to please people who stands in the law. Because we are not of the law anymore. We live for God, and that itself should bring the difference in our family, in your marriage, in our relationship, in our life. We want to make a difference? It starts with you. Separate yourself from your old life. Imagine if both individual, sa relationship, ang lalaki at babae are separated from their old self. Bring them together. What a beautiful couple they would be. Konti lang talaga nag-amen. So, dili pa jud beautiful couple ang Blessed Family. You contribute to the percentage of indivisible relationship. by becoming separated from your old self. Now, ideal? Ah, yes. Separate myself from my old life. Yes. But it doesn't come easy. That is why in becoming intentionally indivisible, you don't just separate yourself from your old life, you have to surrender to your new life. Surrender. Surrender to your new life, not surrender to your new wife. Galatians 2:19-20. I stopped trying to meet all its requirements so I might live for God. Verse 20, my old self has been crucified. It is no longer I who live, but Christ lives in me. What's your new life? Your life with Jesus. What's your new life? A life that you can put your trust to the Son of God who gave himself for you and loved you. That's your new life. However, that's my new life. Amen. But my life is still my life. Let Jesus live in you. Let Jesus work in you. Give him access to transform you. Sabi ni Paul, I can put my trust to the Son of God. I live in this earthly body, but it's no longer I who live. That's access granted for Jesus. Surrender. Accept your new reality. Minsan, no, ideal bitaw talaga ang feeling na, hala, bago na talaga ang buhay ko dahil kay Kristo. Heaven na ako, dili na ako impierno. Bakit ba ako lang bisaya ng bisaya? Sino bang last kausap ko? My point is that ang sarap ng feeling na ganun. Pero put it into application, mahirap palang mag-surrender. Mahirap pala na hindi mo na-control ang buhay mo. Mahirap pala na hindi mo hawak lahat. Bakit? Nasanay tayong hawak mo ang mundo mo. You tried fixing yourself many times. Nakailang New Year's resolution ka nang hindi mo nagawa. Nakailang magbabago na ako. Hindi ko na uulitin to. Hindi na mauulit to. Tawag-tawa yung mga tao malapit sa akin. Hindi ko alam kung ano nangyari sa buhay nyo. Can you try this? Activity lang. Ganyan lang kayo ng 10 minutes. Try natin. Huwag din itutok sa asawa. By doing this with all your force, di ba nakakapagod? Nakaupo ka lang. Right? Masakit. The more that you grip, the harder your grip is, the more it pains. What do you need to do to release yourself from this? Let go. Most of the time, we hold our life. We control our life. I will make this solution. I will solve all my problems. But it's hard. Many times, you try to fix your marriage. Not just your marriage, you fix the person. That's not your life. That's not how marriage works. That's not how relationship works. So in order to see the transformation of your relationship, of your family, let go. Grant that access to Jesus who gave himself for you, who loved you for who you are, who modeled what relationship is, and who showed what commitment is. Surrender to your new life. In order to embrace this new life, you have to be separated from your old life. If lahat may access si Jesus, na baguhin ka, ayusin ka sa mga bagay na hindi mo maayos, even your marriage, even your relationship na pag ikaw ang susolve, hindi na susolusyonan. But if Jesus comes in, individually, you allow Jesus to work in your life, you put yourself together, there's forgiveness, there's grace, there's love, and you can start over again. Amen? If both of you grant access and put your trust to the Son of God who loved you and gave himself for you. Trust the one who loved you. The whole problem is we keep holding. Pag nag-away kayo, umaalis na yung asawa mo. Di ba nanggigigil tayo? Hindi ka nga nagsalita, pero sa mata mo, namatay na siya. Hindi ka nga nagipag-away, pero sa utak mo, nadapa na siya. Remember ko yung isang post. Dami tumatakbo sa isip ko. Nakita ko yung isa, nadapa pa. Are you with me? When we are in control, sometimes it doesn't work. So remember, there's a new life God has granted you to have, to enjoy, to live. That's why get out from your old life, surrender to your new life, and you get to see there's hope. Why? Alam natin tong verse na to, lalong-lalo na pag nagle-lesson ka. 2 Corinthians 5:17, can you read that? 1, 2, 3, go. The old life is gone. The new life has begun. What's the beauty of every beginning? There's a lot of miracles that can happen. Why do we love New Year? We can start over again. We can change our story. We can change how we respond to certain things. That's how our new life is. It's filled with a lot of hope. It's filled of making it right again. But this time, not by yourself, but with Jesus. Amen? That's new life. In relationship, your new life together, when you know Jesus, when you put your life to Jesus, meron bang blessed fam dito na dati hindi naman talaga save yung asawa mo siguro, pero nung na-Bible study, everything turned upside down? Meron ba? I believe so. We hear the testimonies. Nagbago eh. Yung dating maingay. Mas umingay. Parang umingay, pero yung ingay ngayon, may word of God nang kasama. Pero yung word of God, declared niya sa sarili niya, the Lord is patient, the Lord is kind. Are you with me? Narinig ko yun sa side, no? I will not just look at your, kung kanino ko yung narinig. Maingay nga, pero nagpipreach ka na. Ngayon, may term na siya. Hindi ka na niyayaw-yawan, sinesermonan ka na. Preaching na po yun, 3 points pa. Hindi ka nakapaglaba, hindi mo natapon ng basura, hindi ka ganito. Point is that our new life is so beautiful. But we can't fully experience it because 1 foot at the old life, 1 foot comes with the new life. Right? It doesn't work that way. Surrender. This new life offers forgiveness. This new life offers grace. This new life offers love. If you would ask yourself, if you are in the verge of breaking up, will God be glorified? If I will remain to be angry with my husband or with my wife, will God be glorified? You with me? It changes everything. It changes your language. Ang dating hindi pasensyoso, you find yourself being patient. Why? Because God is working and God is patient. You find yourself na dati, mapagtanim ka ng galit, but because God is working in your life, you surrender to your new life, you find yourself forgiving. Are you with me? Amen? That's the beauty of this life. Surrender to that new life. In all of this, the need to be able to separate yourself to your old self, surrender yourself to this new life, create relationship, create a family like no other, be indivisible. In order for this to work individually, you need to be contented. That's why number three, in order to be intentionally indivisible, you have to be satisfied with your partner. Kailangan ko talaga ipasok yung partner, no? Yun kasi yung sinabi ng coach nyo. But there are two partners in this marriage, in relationship. And the first partner, even if you are single, you are partner with him. You have to make sure that you are satisfied and partnered with God. Amen? To make relationship work, partner with the author of love and relationship. That's why Apostle Paul said, anong pinapamukha? Actually, nagyayabang siya in a sense na yabang na, I am reminded of my new life. I am an old prosecutor of the church. Dati akong kalaban niyo. Kaya nire-remind ko yung kalaban ko ulit ngayon. Nakakampi ko na. The words and the heaviness of the words of Apostle Paul in the next verse, verse 21. I do not treat the grace of God as meaningless. For if keeping the law could make us right with God, then there was no need for Christ to die. My old self has been crucified. I'm separated now with my old life. I'm now surrendering that Christ lives in me. This is partnership for me. And while I am in this relationship, I will not treat the grace of the Lord meaningless because it transformed me, it changed me. This is my commitment to my partner. Because if I will not be contented with the one who changed my life, I'm treating the grace of God meaningless. Ikaw pa talaga ang may ganang mag-treat sa grace ni Lord as meaningless. I tried everything. Paul himself is a follower of the law. If you look at the whole life of Paul, he was more boastful that he did not fail the law. He was too righteous before the law. But all of this were nothing compared to Jesus. Amen? How true is this words? Verse 3 of Philippians 6 to 9. I was so zealous that I harshly persecuted the church. And as for righteousness, I obey the law without fault. Sino dito ang hindi pa nakapag-jaywalking ever since? Sino dito ang mga driver at mga motorcycle rider na hindi lumabas ng bahay na walay helmet? It's hard to say that I obeyed the law without fault. But for Paul, he did. But ano yung words na I once thought this were valuable, but now I consider them worthless. Everything was worthless when compared with the infinite value of knowing Jesus. That's contentment. That's satisfaction. And the more that we are satisfied with God, the more that we see ourselves contented with God, the more we see a lot of things in the world, in our perspective, na akala mo yan yung magbibigay sa'yo ng satisfaction, it's all nothing. I'm not saying you don't pursue your career. Go ahead. Pursue your career, but don't find satisfaction on it. Pursue excellence, but don't pursue satisfaction for it. Grow, achieve, do it! But that is not your satisfaction. Your satisfaction is your relationship with our Lord. Once we are contented, satisfied, partnering with God, it will grant us ability to be partnered with people. Satisfied ako kay God? Contented ako sa relationship ko kay God? God is giving me everything that I need, that I don't need another person to fill me and to complete me. I'm sorry to my future husband, you will not complete me. I'm already complete. That's why two becomes one, not one half becomes whole. Diba? Para kang manok na hinati sa gitna. Nung pinanganak ka, hati ka ba? Partnered with people to the point that they will not grant me satisfaction because I'm more than satisfied with God. That's why even the greatest commandment of all time, Matthew 22:35-36, sabi pa ng isang expert na, sabi pa ng mga disciples, "Teacher, which is the most important commandment in the law of Moses?" Ilang commandment ang meron si Moses? Ilang commandments po ang... Ang hirap naman. Ilang commandments ang 10 commandments? Sige daw. Ilang commandments ni Moses? 10! Kung katabi mo yung asawa mo, sabihan mo yung asawa mo, 10 lang ang commandments ni Moses. Imagine, si Moses 10 lang ang commandments, yung partner mo ang dami. Moses gave 10 commandments. Ay, baka hindi si Moses ang pinag-uusapan natin. Because the Jews had 613 commandments. So kung sino mga asawa ang higit sa 10, you are a Jew. Moses gave 10, Jews had 613, Jesus gave 2. And that 2 commandments was replied by Jesus. Next slide, please. "You must love the Lord your God with all of your heart, all of your soul, and all of your mind. This is the first and greatest commandment." Lahat ng yan satisfied with your partner, and that's God Himself. And once we are satisfied with God, what's the next commandment that is equally important? Love your neighbor as yourself. Our satisfaction and contentment in loving God, partnering with God, will give us the ability and access to love people. Your partner was once your neighbor. Your husband, your wife, you're in a relationship with someone who was identified by the Bible as neighbor. Although nasa talon-talon ka na sa Ayala yung isa. My point is that it's the same. Loving God first would make you love your wife, love your husband. Being contented with Jesus, being satisfied with God will make you be satisfied and be contented with your partner. Are you with me? If you cannot find satisfaction in your relationship with God, don't expect that you would be satisfied and be contented with your partner. Because once we are satisfied with our relationship with the Lord, we are in a relationship with a perfect being. And before God, I see myself as imperfect. So why would I expect my partner to be perfect? If that person fails, your husband fails, your wife fails, what is God doing in my relationship with him when I fail? He gives me grace. He gives me forgiveness. So when I come in now with my relationship with people, in the same way as God to me, this is going to be me to her or to him. Are you with me? That satisfaction. Hindi ko hanapin yung kulang sa kanya. Pinakasalan mo nga. Minahal mo nga na hindi pa siya. Meaning you will embrace all the flaws. But what will carry you through that relationship, carry you through with that partnership, it's your satisfaction with your relationship with the Lord. If I love God, I can love people. You cannot love people enough if you don't love God. You cannot also say that you love God and you don't love people. It comes together. Kaya sabi niya, the second is equally important. You cannot live on your own. You need people. Try mo daw, pumunta ka ng supermarket, walang magbabayad, wala di magbibigay sa'yo ng ano. Walang tutulong sa'yo. You need people. We live in this world that we need people. Jesus saw the need of people while giving and granting, creating an Eve to partner with Adam. Because he saw, even if Adam had everything, all the riches, all the companions animalistically, Adam needed a companion. We need people. And we are called to love people. You are not just to love your wife, to love your husband, to love your father, your mother. You are called to love people, whoever they are, whatever status they are in. Even if you are strangers, we are called to love people. Why can we love people? Because we love God. Amen. If we want that, we will start a culture of indivisible relationship, marriages, families. It starts with your contribution individually. My mindset should change. My heart should change. My life should be aligned with God. And that's when we can contribute to percentages of successful marriage. Oops. Successful marriage ba? No. That's not our goal. Our goal is to have godly marriage, godly families, godly relationships, built by godly people. Individually, we should start working together as godly people of God that will give Him the glory. Amen? Fight for your relationships. Live as how God wants this relationship to be. As I request the music team to come, I want you to evaluate the kind of relationship, friendships that you are building in your life or you have in your life. I do not know if you are like me, but there was a time last year when Senior Pastor Jade shared about the topic. Ang result at action steps ko sa kanyang session during the Deacon Breakout Session. Lord, can you remind me again of the people I gave up loving? Sabi pa ng Senior Pastor Daryl natin, talaga? You gave up on people? Because no matter how you see a person so loving, we're just human beings. And yes, I did give up loving people. I started building a wall. And last year was God's work in me that I have to push that wall again. Let people come into my life. Let myself be offered to their life, even if it will not be returned the same. Even if I will find myself alone again, even if I have seen people who are in their groups, who are friends with a lot of friends, and I see myself alone, that's okay. Because my satisfaction is in the Lord. Pero nag-fail ako saan? I am satisfied with the Lord. I do not need people. Wait, what? No, the Word of God says, if I'm satisfied with the Lord, it's equally important to love my neighbor. So I have to push that wall, break that wall, and start believing in love again. Reminding you again, I'm a single person. I'm not fighting for love because I'm in a relationship. No. It's just a love for friends, love for family, love for people I'm with. Did I got tired? Yes. But the word of the Lord says, in order to unite, I cannot unite the whole church, but I can contribute to the unity of the body of Christ, even if it's 0.1% only. So I have to look at my life. What do I believe in? I have to start fighting for relationship, fighting for my love for people, fight for my family, fight for my relationships, fight for what we want our community to be. Believe in this hope. Believe in the kind of culture we wanna bring into this society that will make a difference. In studies, Christians are only 3% here in our city. And we do not know the rest of the 2%, and we might just be 0.05% of it. But if we will contribute to the totality of this 3% and make a difference, then let's do it. Let's fight for it. Fight for your husband and your wife. Not fight with them. Fight for them. Fight for your relationship with your father, your mother, your siblings. Fight for your relationship with your friends. Make a difference. You don't give up on them. If you're on the verge of giving up, give it up to Him. Why can we trust Him? Why can we say that we can fight for all of this? Because He did for me, for you. Let's be a generation that would change and make a difference in our society. I declare my generation, I am a contributor of a godly family. If you came from a broken home, break the curse for that family. If people saw that your family is filled with relatives of separation, break that curse in your family. Starts with you. Not your husband, not your wife, not your mother, not your father, you. Let's change our mindset. The song that we sang earlier, Love is War. Yeah, we are in a war. And we need soldiers to fight for this. Believe in the relationship God designed. Believe in the love that God has created. And we are carriers of that love. Shall we all rise? The lyrics of the song says, I will fight. Not we will. I will fight. I hope that will be your declaration today. Let's intentionally be indivisible contributors of our society today and fight for love that God gave.